guys, today I'm in my office and I'm going to be talking about the 2016 Mobile Electronics Expo and Training that we had here in Vancouver, Richmond for pretty much all of Western Canada for the 12-volt industry. It was really interesting. Before I get on that though, I want to say thank you for everyone that's been watching all the 350Z videos and who's been commenting, because it actually helps me, good or bad. I probably leave actually about 99% of the bad comments with the good. I've never deleted a good comment. But I like to let people voice their opinions, no, as much as they don't agree with me. I think it's a good thing, because people need to be heard. There are, though, however, some people that kind of take it a little bit too far, where I do remove their comments, because it just pretty much borderline cyberbullying, and then I just get annoyed, because it's just banter back and forth between me and the keyboard hero. So, enough of that. Another thing I want to note is, we also partnered up with IJDM Toys, which is really cool because I don't carry a lot of lighting in my line of work, and it seems to be a very big growing market. And what I like about these guys is they do a lot of really good vehicle specific lighting. If you watch the last few videos where I actually did the switchback LED bumper lights on the 350Z, that was from those guys. And upcoming, we're going to do a video that's going to take a few days to film, because I have to pull the rear bumper off on the car and send it out to paint because it's got a bunch of damage on it. I bought the car used, not me. And you have to remove the bumper to actually install these lights. So I figured, well, if we're going to paint the bumper, then why don't we put these badass lights in and then show people how to make your car look really cool without actually modifying the aesthetics of the car too much. So the cool thing about the Mobile Electronics Expo and Training is it's the first of its kind in Canada. So this has literally never been done officially, and it was really cool to see all the big distributors and retailers come together and learn from top dogs in the States and how they're doing things down south and what makes them the best of what they do. So we had Trends, Gentech, Jensen, Automobility, the guys from Directed were up. All the major manufacturers were there and distributors to help train us and show us what's out there that helps us give you guys better solutions for the 12-volt industry, because it's changing quite a bit and we have to be trained on a regular basis to keep up with new trends, because if we don't keep up with what you guys want, we can't deliver a good product at a fair price, because you know, it's all about speed, but then people want the quality as well, and it all has to work 100%. And these are major challenges that we have to deal with. So this whole video, I'm just going to basically show what it was like in small snippets of what it was like to be there. And to put in perspective, it was like Knowledge Fest or a CES on like a really, really tiny scale. Keep in mind, this was the first show of its kind here in Canada, and our population for the whole country is equivalent to that of California, so you can understand that we're a growing market in the 12-volt industry, and I think we're a very strong market because there's a lot of passionate people that work up here in it, but it's still quite small. But I think because it's so small, and a lot of people that were good at it are pretty much out of the game now, the quality of workmanship you've seen across the board come out from here is really high on average, because there's fewer of us. So there's pros and cons, but I think it's a market that needs to be focused on to help grow the industry itself. So I am now going to show you guys what it was like to be there at the show.
Setup day.
He's pulling straight in.
Hey, look, for once I'm not working.
You're my friend! Oh, I hate waking up. This is early for me.
Composite filler. We make body filler, and we spend most of our time trying to not really use that much of it at all, because that's where you'll start to eat up all your time. All this sanding and sculpt, we're supposed to be fabricators, right, not sculptors. So when we take two pieces of wood and we stack them together and we start piling on body filler, no.
Well, we could order one. We didn't want to order. He wants it built.
Right, so what I'm watching for here isn't the perfection. Does that make sense? So this should, therefore you don't require to learn tap, or it assumes tap. Therefore you don't need to learn it. But it will tell you why it doesn't want to learn.
What's coming in on that channel? Alright? Super simple, right? Now you have a visual representation of what you have coming in. So you go through, you hardwire in your inputs, and then it'll show you exactly what you have. Now you switch over to output view.
I'm Steve Brown. I'm the Senior Restyle Product Development Manager at Alpine. That means that basically I run the marketing department and the promotional aspects of what we do, as well as the product development. So a lot of the stuff that you see from the Restyle realm is directly a result of what I do on a day-to-day basis at Alpine. It's pretty interesting. We get to get really hands-on with cars. We get to do things that nobody else is doing in the industry with these systems. What we're doing with Restyle is we're creating the ultimate premium system, right?
So this is kind of what it's like at the training. Is when it's all said and done on the first or second day, we just drink a lot. So yeah, it's kind of fun to hang out in places like this, I guess, and learn a bit.
Our audio, for some reason, the better the profession you are, the more you should get paid. I got paid. I understand, hey, I get to go to work today, somebody's going to pay. I get to go to work today, I don't got to go to work, I get to go to work today and somebody's going to pay. Now what I want to inform you today is that when you go to work, you're going to get paid and you're going to get paid more money.
You look at it, you think that's not too bad, I could just take this out, jam a tune-in radio in there. And because I have climate controls here, these buttons obviously just wouldn't do anything, but I can pretty much run my climate all hunky-dory, right? So what's wrong with that plan? Who knows what's wrong with that plan? No. You look here, and you think, man, I got a lot of climate controls. You're very close. You're knocking on the door there. But there's a problem. What is the problem? Anyone know? Nope. Look very carefully at this cluster, because some OE engineer, what's kind of nice and unique to them is this icon of the truck is actually dynamically assigned by what you flash. If you flash a sedan or a car, it's going to be a car. If you flash a truck, it's going to be a truck. If you flash an SUV, it's
going to be a car. Anymore, and this will do up to a four-way system. So you can see over there on the right of the screen, I took a two, a three, and a four-way system, and I summed them. Not particularly flat responses, though, are they? Because this is only one thing that it does. The other thing that it's going to do is take those things and go ahead and apply reverse equalization and flatten them out. You'll wind up with a really nice signal on the output. All right. Sorry, the acoustics in the room here aren't that great, but we're not here for sound quality, so. How does it sound? So this is time correction on. Let's turn it on now.
Needing a radio at all. We can use our telephone or our iPad, Android or iOS, as our source unit. And we can stream music straight into our system without an OE radio or anything.
Well guys, hopefully you liked seeing the inside look of what it was like to be at a trade show like that. To see what else I'm up to, make sure to check out my Facebook and Instagram, AnthonyJ350, and check out our website at www.gofasthavefun.ca.